Welcome to Honest Book Reviews. If you are new to the channel, please subscribe. Today we will be reviewing The Rosie Project, a novel book by Graham Simsion. Don, a literate scathing speaker, is a professor of biological gene study, while Rosie, a redhead, is a social castaway with plenty of emotional sparks who was set adrift by two events. Her mother died and her father lied to her about a planned Disneyland trip and then abandoned her. Don sets out to obtain a wife, of course, by making up a quiz to grade women and determine if they were worth the effort to court. It is very funny to see the reaction of the women who think Don's idea and his entire approach to life is bizarre, dark, and one to avoid. The character Don caught between saying what is socially acceptable and blurting out responses from Asperger's contains the author's best writing and his most comic. The Rosie Project by Graham Simsion is one of those rare finds that can be enjoyed by most everyone, no matter what your perceived genre in books to be. When any two people have vastly different perspectives, things can get pretty crazy, whether the source of the difference is age, culture, education, and or neurologically based. Maybe that's the way it works over time, or maybe that's the way it works for the plot in this book. Don, a genetics professor, is quickly pulled into the project of collecting DNA samples and testing them to find the answer. What ensues is a lovely, funny, and sweet love story in which our clueless protagonist gets a few clues about human connection. Is there only one story in existence about Down's syndrome or childhood cancer? While these two characters share similarities and perhaps fall somewhere on the autism spectrum, neither has been officially diagnosed with Asperger's by his creator. As they begin working on the father project, Don realizes clearly that Rosie is not a good candidate for a wife. Along comes Rosie, who on the face of it would fail most of Don's questionnaire asking for his help as a geneticist to find her biological father. This takes them all over even New York, where Don learns that staying on a schedule isn't always a good thing. It could have easily been a book that passed judgment and poked fun at Don's mode of operation, but instead the subject was handled with tact and grace. As Don goes through the questionnaire as his friend Jean helped to hand out, there is one that Don unknowingly was set up on a date with, according to the misinformation that Jean gave her Rosie about the wife project questionnaire. Her mother was known to get around back in her college days, so there are many possibilities as to who Rosie's father may be. Don has the automatic ability to see the need to live his life in an organized and analytical manner for maximum efficiency. Personal interactions and emotions are troublesome for him. The author is able to point out the pitfalls of making a list of absolute options required for a wife from an Asperger's point of view. The story was presented with a healthy balance of both humor and reality, and it was eye-opening in regards to the rigors of daily life for someone with AS. The story is about a quirky, socially awkward college professor named Don who designs a scientific survey to find the perfect wife for himself. While Rosie herself feels much more realistic, with personality flaws and limitations that manage to make her both alluring and human. Believing that Rosie is pre-qualified as a potential wife, Don asks her to dinner at a fancy restaurant which requires jackets for gentlemen. Rosie takes two bottles of white wine from the refrigerator, and Don tells her that alcohol is not scheduled for Tuesdays. Suffice it to say, this story is well worth a quick read and gives you a true empathy for people like Don and their struggle to find their place in a world not always welcoming to anyone who is different. He devises a questionnaire and distributes it with the help of his university advisor, superior, and best friend Jean, a womanizing man in an open marriage who is determined to bed a woman from every country on the globe. Such forays into traditional mating rituals having proved to be complete wastes of time, money, and his not inconsiderable intellectual resources, and so Don has abandoned his search. With the scientific rubrics in place, Don is sure of long-term scientifically validated success until Rosie Jarman walks into his office. Rosie is ostensibly a wife project applicant, but one also in search of her biological father, the latter a quest Don is imminently suitable with which to assist. Wink author Graham Simsion takes his background in it consulting and screenwriting to craft a fast-paced, charming debut novel as full of unabashed romantic heart as it is of the scientific precision with which Don constructs and lives every aspect of his life. Rarely is a novel so perfectly suited for film as The Rosie Project is, essentially the classic screwball romantic comedy in novel form. Afterwards, reading about how the book was written, you realize what a labor of love it was to write this seemingly light-hearted rom through the trials of an obsessive-compulsive academic to find a suitable mate. And there's a subplot concerning Rosie's unknown biological father, and then Don changes, and then Rosie says no, and then. In a lot of ways, it's like spending a few hours inside the beautiful mind of the Big Bang Theory's Sheldon Cooper. Thank you for watching. Do not forget to subscribe and leave your comments below.